Hi children, today we will going to learn the new chapter, that is directions and map. It's really an interesting chapter. See, in this picture two people are sitting opposite to each other. The first is A and the second one is B. The first A person is seeing the wall. Person B is seeing the girl and the wall behind her. Even if they are sitting together, the right of A is not same as what is to the right of B. Why? Even as sitting at the same house, they cannot locate the exact position of the wall. Watch. So to sort out this problem, the directions come into existence. Directions identify the exact position of an object. The direction come into existence. Direction are used to say exactly where object is located. The four main directions are north, south, east and west. How to identify their positions? The east is opposite to west and the south is opposite to north. Now a question must be arising in your mind, how to identify the directions. Let us understand the directions with the help of these two pictures. The direction in which the sun rises is the east and the direction in which the sun sets is west. See this child. This child is facing towards the sunrise, that is toward the east. So his right hand is toward south and his left hand will direct towards the north. So if you stand facing toward east, behind is your west. That means east and west are opposites to each other and north and south are opposites to each other. Why we use the sun for the direction identification? Because it arises daily and sets daily. So when the sun rises, you can easily identify the direction, that is east. Now see the next picture. In this picture, this boy is facing towards south and behind him is the north. So south and north both are opposites to each other. Now this boy right hand is towards the west and his left hand is towards the east. So west and east are opposites to each other. So from these two pictures we can easily get the direction how to identify it. You can do this activity in the open sunrise. So it will help you to understand better. Now this is your house and you have to frame the north, east, south and west direction and also the things available near your house. That is a neighbor house near your house or a shop and a tree, a bus stop and a road. In this way you can locate in the north, east, west and south direction. You can locate according to your house and the locations of the things available near you. Now this is a magnetic needle in which the compass always lies in the north and south direction. This needle helps us to identify the direction in the north and south side. Now see what's the solution. Sai and Abhay have been asked to solve this problem. Can you help them? Yes, we can. She is Sara and he is Amir. Ice cream shop and here is a bus stop. First, only the east position was given in the test book, so we have labeled all the other direction like this: south, west, north and east is already given. Now Sara, see in this picture the east is marked. Use that to write the other three directions in the yellow boxes. We have already written this. See, south, west, north. In which direction do we travel to go from the ice cream shop to the bus stop? Question number B. So we will travel from ice cream shop to bus stop. here we have to go from ice cream shop to bus stop. So we will go towards the east direction. So our answer B is east. Okay, now answer number C. Now first see the question. Amir wants to go to the ice cream shop. In which direction he must walk? Amir wants to go to the ice cream shop. So Amir should go from here to here. That means he should go towards the west. See, here is west. So he will go towards the west direction. Like this. Okay. So the answer number C is west. Sara wants to go to the bus stop. In which direction must she go? She is Sara and Sara wants to go to the bus stop. She will go towards the north direction, as it is written north over here. So she will go to the north direction. I hope you understand all the questions and you can. Now use of direction in maps. In maps, the directions are always shown with arrow, which we have to match with the direction of the surrounding by keeping your map down on the ground. This will help you to identify the direction clearly. India is my country. We have used this sentence in our pledge. You must have heard the word world, nation, state, and now in this chapter we are going to see the new words, that is earth, world, country, state, district, taluka, and even villages through the maps. Now we all live in a house. Our houses are built on lands. This land is very far and wide. A vast section of land on the earth is called a continent. So in our globe there are some space for the land, and this space occupied is known as continent, and the remaining places are covered with the waters, which are known as oceans. So the earth is also called as world. There are many countries on the land on earth. The countries are made of several states. We live in a state of Maharashtra, and our country name is India, which is made of many district, taluka. Now India and world have been given in this lesson, so we will see one by one the maps of district, state, country and the whole globe in this chapter, and we will going to identify the questions and answers with the help of an index. Now what is an index? An index in a map is a symbol for picture, sign and different shades of colors, which are used to represent the information in a map. That is, this index provides certain information about the map, that is specific information to indicate something. A list of these symbols etc. is given along with the map. This list is called the index. The index helps us to understand the map easily. Now this is the map of Brihan Mumbai major place. This is the district map of Mumbai. Here there are two districts. As you can see in the picture, Mumbai suburban district and Mumbai city district. Mumbai is the one of the biggest city of India, and Mumbai is also the capital of Maharashtra. See, here there is an index shown below in this box. This line indicates district boundary. See how the boundary is drawn from here to here. It separates Mumbai city district from Mumbai suburban district. This black color dotted indicates the district headquarters. The first headquarter is in Bandra and the another is in Fort. Now this green color box indicates reclaimed land, as you can see over here. And the most important is the direction which is shown over here. The upward is north, the downward is south. Here it is west and east. So the map always shows these two things, that is the index and the direction. Now let us see the question and answer one by one. In the box given along with your district, write the name of the place where you live. Suppose we live in BKC, that is Bandra Kurla complex. You can give any of the place name where you live. Now the question number two, circle the name of the headquarters of your district. So the headquarter of your district is in Bandra. Exactly, you are staying in BKC, so this Bandra you have to circle. Now the question number three, draw a box around the names of the district neighboring your district. So our district is Mumbai suburban district, so our neighbor district will be exactly Mumbai city district. So we have to draw a box around this Mumbai city district. Now question number four is, write the names of two major places near the boundary between Mumbai city district and Mumbai suburban district. So the name of the two important places, one is Kurla and another is Sion. As you can see the answer, write the name of the district to the north of your district in the box. So in the north of the district, that is in the upward direction, which district will become Thane district. See, this totally will come under the Thane district. See, as you can see in this map, easily Thane district is towards the north. So we have to write here Thane district. I hope you understand this Mumbai district map easily, and you can answer this in your textbook also. Now the next map is of our Maharashtra state. See, this is the map of our Maharashtra state, and all the districts are in the Maharashtra state is given over here. Now this is the state boundary. As you can see over here, all the state boundaries lines, how it is drawn, district boundary inside the Maharashtra state. See this lines for district boundary. See, between Nashik and Thane also you can see. And this black color dot line indicates state capital. So where is our state capital? It's Mumbai. And the another one is second capital, that is the Nagpur. It is also denoted by a black color spot. So this is our index. As we know, in every map the index will show, and the directions also. See the direction over here, there is a north, south, west and east. So let us see the question and answer. First, find your district on the map and color it. So we stay in Mumbai, so we will color our Mumbai district over here, as we have done already. Now the second question is, a box is given in the index to represent your district. Color it in the same color. Write the name of your district after my district in the index. As shown in the map, we have done this. See, here it is yellow color, so we have filled this box also with yellow color, and we have given the name Mumbai district as we stay here. If someone stays in another district, he can do the same by coloring Pune or writing Pune over here and filling this box with some color, same as Pune. Okay, now see the question number three. In the box below, write the names of the district neighboring your district. So our district is in Mumbai, so we will write Thane and Raigarh, as they are very close neighbors of ours. So Thane and Raigarh are the two district. Okay, I hope you understand Maharashtra state map. It's very easy to understand. Just you see the directions and the index carefully and you can answer anything. Now come to a most important part of the map, that is our country map. As we all love our country, see, this is our country map, India. Everyone must be aware of this map and familiar also. See the direction it is given over here, north, south, west and east. Here there is again an index in the box. This line is international boundaries. See how the international boundaries are made for the map of India. See, these are the boundaries map line given over here. See all the boundaries. Now see the state boundaries. Between two states there are boundaries, between Madhya Pradesh and UP. You can see these lines. It indicates the boundaries for the state separation. That is, it separates the state from state. National capital. Which is our national capital, children? Yes, our national capital is New Delhi. See, here it is denoted by a circle as it is given in the index also. It is very important to see the index first so you can understand the map easily. Now, in this picture, only what we have to do is circle our state. In this picture, we have to only color our state. So, we have already colored our state boundaries with red color. That is, our state name is Maharashtra. Okay, that's it. Now, this is the largest map. That is the globe, whole globe, all the continents and all the water bodies are given over here. See, this white space indicates the continents and this light blue color indicates the water bodies. See, Indian Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Pacific Ocean, Arctic Ocean, and this all are continents. Europe, Africa, South America, Asia, North America and Antarctica. You can easily go through it and see the names of the continents and the water bodies over here. So our continent name is Asia. We live in the continent of Asia and this is our country's map. See, this is our country map. So the first question is, in the map of the world given above, color the part labeled India. This is our India and we have already colored it with red color. See, this part you have to color. Now the question number 2 is, color the box next to the map in the same color and write India on the dotted line. So this is the square box. Here you have to color the same color what you have done in the map. See, here you have colored India map with red color. So you have to color it here also. And we have written the name of our dear country, that is India. This much you have to do in this map. It's very easy to identify in this map. So I hope you understand. The key point in this chapter was the four main direction: north, south, east and west. The uses of the direction given on the map and also the use of index and the introduction to our district, state and country and also the globe using the map. This video is directed by Empowering Your Knowledge. So please subscribe our channel Empowering Your Knowledge. I hope you like the video.